आई एम नितेश मित्तल फ्रॉम चितकारा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी राजपुरा पंजाब। आवर टीम इज पार्टिसिपेंट ऑफ टीआई एनालॉग डिजाइन कंटेस्ट 2012-13 एंड वी आर टीम ए फ्रॉम आवर कॉलेज। वी आर प्रोवाइडेड विद द प्रॉब्लम इन विच देयर इज सेकंड ऑर्डर लो पास फिल्टर कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ यूनिटी गेन ऑप एम्प TL082 इन लूप विद अनदर यूनिटी गेन ऑप एम्प TL082 serving as voltage buffer to the first. The transfer function of the system is V naught upon V in equal to alpha square A square upon 1 plus alpha A plus alpha square A square, where alpha is the dimension constant and is equal to R1 upon R1 plus R2. The output of first op-amp is fed to the input of second through our attenuator alpha, and relation VB is equal to alpha VA stands to VA is equal to A into VE minus V naught, where A is open loop gain, and the output of second is VC equal to A into VB minus V naught, where VB is the input to the second open, and V naught is equal to alpha VC also stands to here.
I am Jay Aditya. Now I will take you to the hardware implementation of the circuit. We are using AS11K version 2010 kit, which is used for basic analog designs. We have multiple op-amps here, which can be configured in either of the inverting and non-inverting form. We have used type 2 of 2 op-amp here. The circuit is made and the input supply which we have used is a regulated is provided plus minus 10 volts. The input is provided through the function generator which is capable of deriving the circuit, and the output we have on the CRO. The channel 1 of the CRO is the input of the circuit, channel 2 of the CRO is output of the circuit. This waveform is of channel 1, this is of channel 2. Now, for plotting the frequency curves, I am going to change the frequency and measure the values of input and output to get gain. Now, I am applying the 1 kHz frequency to the circuit. As you can see, there is no difference between the waveforms. We can conclude that there is no phase difference, and we can see the multiplication factor is similar to both the inputs and both are overlapping, so gain is 1. Increasing the frequency and going up to 1 MHz frequency, we can take the readings and get the values of gain to plot the frequency response curve. The cutoff frequency comes near 240 kHz. Now, turning to the XY mode, we can see the Lesagius pattern. I'll come back to that later. As you can see, as I am increasing the frequency, the gain is varying. The Lesagius pattern is drawn with respect to input and output. The pattern we are getting is this one. The sine theta, which depicts the phase difference, is equal to sine inverse A upon B, where A is the intersection of the Lesagius pattern with y axis and B is the maximum value of Lesagius pattern on y axis. Now I am going to simulate the circuit diagram using TINA. The circuit is made and sine wave is applied for the AC analysis of the circuit. For AC analysis, I am providing frequency from 100 Hz to 1 MHz as specified in the problem statement. The gain and phase plot with frequency are here, and we can see that cutoff frequency is coming around 240 kilohertz. Corresponding value of the phase is approaching to 64 degree.
Now coming to the major learning as well as challenge we faced in this experiment, we have obtained a cutoff frequency equal to 200 kHz as gain in dB equal to 2.27 dB and voltage gain we can obtain equal to 1.3. Now gain bandwidth product, commonly known as GB, equal to gain into bandwidth, also can be written as gain and FC into cutoff frequency, which is equal to 260 kHz. For general op-amps, in open loop condition, bandwidth is narrow with a higher gain as compared to closed loop with a wide bandwidth and a lower gain. The area under the curve at open loop is equal to the area under the curve at closed loop. And now coming to the TL082 part, typical gain bandwidth product is equal to 3 MHz, which is the theoretical value. For calculating the experimental value, we can obtain Vc upon V0 equal to 11 from this circuit, where 11 is the attenuation constant also. Here Vc upon Vn equal to 14.3, and experiment gain bandwidth product of TL082 comes up to be 2.9 MHz, which is approximately equal to the typical gain bandwidth product. So our experiment stands true. In the end, we can conclude that gain bandwidth product is the characteristic to judge an op-amp, which is our major learning from this experiment as well as challenge we face to calculate the gain bandwidth product. And thank you for listening.